Hey, we want to come to you and talk to you for a few moments what a church can do in a time of crisis like what we're experiencing with the coronavirus. We believe that we can connect a person that has a need with people within the church that can fill that need. We're calling it our care ministry. Maybe this, if you're finding us and you attend another church, maybe you want to talk to your pastor and talk to your church about how could you do this also. We're using a texting system so that a care ministry can connect a person that says, I'm out of bread, I'm out of milk, I'm out of baby formula, I'm out of diapers, I'm out of toilet paper, and people in the church say, but I can help in that need. Here's how care ministry is going to work. The number is going to be up on the screen. This is our texting system. It's 909-637-3339. If you notice, if you'll text to that, the word care, what you're doing is you're signing up for our care ministry. It's saying, I'm willing to supply someone when they're in need, that I can be receiving a text from the church that there's this need out there, and if I can meet it, I want to meet it. So we're hoping that many of the ARC families and even the neighbors will say, I'm going to text in to 909-637-3339 and put the word care. I'm going to sign up to be an army in this time of people's needs. Now, if you have a need, here's what you do. 909-637-3339, and you would text the word help. When you put that word help in there, our church will text you or call you, whichever way we can connect with you. We will take down what your need is, and then we send out that to our texting system, to our care ministry. So if you have a need, you put in to that number, 909-637-3339, the word help, and we will then move it so a text goes out to everybody that signed up for care ministry and who could best meet your need. We will put that together so that the person that has the resources can give the resources to the person that needs it. I believe this is going to be vital for the days and the weeks ahead to alleviate the fear, especially for our shut-ins, the older people that are afraid to go to the stores and they can't find what they need when they go there. But this is open to all, that you can be on either side of the equation. The care ministry, sign it up by putting the word care in. If you have a need, put the word help in. We want to help you. Now, we also want to tell you that we are keeping our doors open. Our doors are open on Wednesday nights at 7 o'clock. We have a service. We go verse by verse. We're in the book of 2 Thessalonians. We're open on Sunday mornings at 10:30. We're going through the book of Ephesians. We're going to have a special communion service here. Now, here's what you need to know. This is what the state's saying. As of this is Tuesday night that I'm sending this out, and yes, I know what the latest of the county, I just got it about an hour ago. There is a panic level because of people getting the coronavirus. But I want you to hear this. Here's what they're telling you. Stay home if you or your child are sick. It means if you got a cold, if you got a cough, all that, stay at home. Okay? Stay home if you're a high-risk person. What's a high-risk person? It's if you have an underlying health issue, if you traveled abroad, stay home. If you or a household member has tested positive, stay home. Our doors will not close because we believe as adults you need a place of refuge in the time of the storm. That's what the ark was all about. We want to bring that to you. Now, if you stay home, we're going to connect with you. Why and how? Because the body of Christ is more than a building. But there is something powerful that takes place when we do gather together. Here's what we're going to do. We have gone live streaming. Join us for live streaming both Wednesday night and Sunday mornings, 7 p.m. on Wednesday night, 10:30 on Sunday mornings. And here's how you can be a part of it. We want you to first participate with us. Worship along with us. Don't just sit there and be a spectator. Pray when we're praying and text us comments through YouTube. Let us know who's watching with you and what your needs are and how we're doing. communicate with us. As a matter of fact, that texting to us on Wednesday night, we do interactive. If you have a question about end times, that's where we're at on Wednesday nights, you can text it in and we'll answer it live there on Wednesday night for you. So this is what we're trying to bring, a community that isn't afraid to keep its doors open, and we have all the precautions in place through our medical teams that have done everything here, that the doctors and the nurses in our church here have said we are doing an excellent job in that realm to keep people safe here. We're taking extra precautions for that. Now, besides that, we're this communion service, we want you to participate. This Sunday, we're going to have communion cups. Yes, they're going to be sealed. They're sealed cups with the wafer on top. People that will be putting them will have gloves on, will put them in the tray, so no one has touched your cup with their fingers. There's no bacteria, and you can participate in a communion service that's going to give you some idea of how communion and the rapture actually are connected. If you've never heard that, you'll want to find our channel on arcnaz.com and watch Sunday morning at 10:30, or come here if you feel comfortable in coming to the church during this season. We're going to have a communion service. We want you to participate. Now watch, for those that could be home, especially if you're older, you go, okay, I get this cup, and let me show you the next slide here. It's actually a person, that's what the cup looks like. You pull the lid off and the wafer's there, and then the next slide, you pull the next cover off, and the cup for the, you now have the body and the blood of Christ represented in communion. That's what we're going to do. Now, you say, but I don't have that in my home. We put this out early enough here. Hopefully, you're seeing this on Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, or Saturday before church. You can contact the church. Call the church. Here's the phone number, how to get your communion. The phone number's there. It's different than our texting system. This is, you're going to get a live person, and you're going to call, and they'll say, how many communion cups do you need to be able to have communion in your home if you're going to take communion with us at home? These are just a few of the things that we're looking to do during this crisis to let you feel like we are church, just like God prepared everything for this day and time, that we are doing what the Old Testament tribe of Issachar, we understand the times and we know what to do to bring you still into the presence of God, whether it's here or at home. We want you to feel as if the one thing of hope that's a necessity still for this community, one of the things the state's saying is this a necessity? I believe to have a place of hope and a place of prayer and a place where you can hear the word is a necessity today, and not just empty churches. You're adults. You know whether or not God is calling you to come here or be home. We don't make any judgment on that. We're keeping the ark doors open until one day does God close it. We're praying for you. I'm going to pray with you here in closing. Father, I pray for all those that have found this video, that churches will also put together a system of care ministry to their world, that they will do more than just ask those to watch from home and be a spectator. Lord, teach us how to do house church for those that are in their houses. Teach us to be a realm of faith that we can still gather together. For your word says, don't forsake the gathering together, and all the more as you see the day approaching. Lord, I've also just activated in this care ministry your word right before those verses, don't forsake the gathering together, and all the more as you see the day approaching. The verse before that said, consider how to spur one another onto good deeds. Hebrews 10:24. May many be spurred onto good deeds, connecting a need with a person that can answer that need. Let it be so, we pray, in Jesus' name. Amen.